Antenatal assessment. Antenatal assessment consists of history collection and physical examination. In this video, we are going to see in detail antenatal history collection. History that needs to be collected include vital statistics, family history, personal history, past medical and surgical history, past and present obstetric history. Let's see them one by one in detail. Vital statistics. We write down the profile of the patient as we do in any other specialty. But there are some important points and additional information that need to be included in the profile of an obstetric patient. These are age, occupation, marital status, obstetric score, LMP, gestational age, EDD, and the husband's profile. Why is age important? Extremes of age, both teenage pregnancy and an elderly primary gravida, are obstetric risk factors. We need to know the occupation of the patient to identify any excessive physical activity, stress, or occupational hazards and advise them to reduce such activities. In marital history, we mention how long she's been married. Obstetric score gives a brief idea about the obstetric history of the patient. The exact date of the first day of the last menstrual period is important to calculate the gestational age and the expected date of delivery. Gestational age has to be expressed in terms of completed weeks. We'll also collect the husband's profile, especially the educational status and the occupation, because this gives a fair idea about the socioeconomic background. This detail is needed to anticipate the complications, to give reasonable and realistic antenatal advice and family planning guidance. A detailed family history of any chronic illness, communicable diseases, malignancies, epilepsy, or blood disorders should be asked. The family history of any genetic abnormalities, hereditary disorders, or multiple pregnancies is very important to be noted in an antenatal history. Under personal history, we check if the patient is adequately nourished, if she is able to sleep well, or if there's any sleep disturbances, about personal hygiene and bowel and bladder pattern. Constipation and increased frequency and urgency of micturition is common during pregnancy. Ask about her immunization status and exposure to any drugs or medicines, and any non-allergies should be noted. A detailed marital history, including the duration of marriage and consanguinity. If it's a consanguineous marriage, mention the degree of consanguinity. Under sexual history, we ask if there's any pain or bleeding during coitus and the details of contraceptive use. We collect a detailed menstrual history, the age at menarche, if the cycles are regular, the duration and frequency of the cycles, the amount of blood flow, and the LMP. Past medical and surgical history. Any relevant medical history of communicable diseases, childhood illness, and chronic diseases should be noted. If there's any such medical history, find out how long they have the illness and the details of treatment and medications. Any previous surgery, both general and gynecological, is to be noted in the surgical history. In multigravid patients, we collect a detailed past obstetric history in order. It includes the details of both the mother and the baby. The mother's details include the details of the pregnancy, the mode of conception, if it was spontaneous or if she took any fertility treatment, if the pregnancy was uneventful or if she had some complications. Mention the outcome of the pregnancy, if it was a term or preterm delivery or a miscarriage. Note if the labor was uneventful or if she had some intranatal complications. Find out the method of delivery, if it was a normal vaginal delivery or LSES or instrumental or any other assisted delivery. Find out if there was any complications in the postnatal period. If not, mention that the puerperium was uneventful. These are the information you need to collect about the mother. About the baby, note the sex of the baby. It's very important to know the birth weight of the baby. What was the baby's condition at birth? Whether the baby cried at birth? Note the Apgar score if the details are available from the previous medical records or if the mother can tell you. Find out if there was any congenital anomalies in the baby. You also need to know the present health status of the baby. If the baby is alive and well, ask how long the baby was breastfed and the vaccination status. Next is the present obstetric history, that is the details of the present pregnancy. We'll note the number of previous antenatal visits or whether this is her first antenatal checkup. Find out about her immunization status, especially TT. Ask if she experienced any of the minor disorders in pregnancy. Ask if there was any exposure to radiation or drugs, especially teratogens. The events and details in each trimester should be carefully noted. Important points to be noted in the first trimester are about confirmation of pregnancy and folic acid supplementation. In second trimester, we ask about the quickening, when she felt the quickening for first time, and ensure she is taking iron and calcium supplements. In third trimester, ask about the fetal movements, if she is maintaining a daily fetal movement count, and make sure it is good. Ask if there's any bleeding or leaking PV. And make note of any complications and complaints in each trimester. That's all about antenatal history collection. Hope it is clear to you all, and see you in the next video with antenatal physical examination. Thank you.